guard.
Wasted time. Joe was better last week.
Strange. Where did this mound come from? Oh boy, you're a big one, aren't you?
Thank you.
stop for a bit.
I've never seen a machine like that. Whoa! Nor a hunter so bold. Take this. It's from the quarry stores, but no one's gonna argue that you don't deserve it. May you walk in the light, friend. Especially when dealing with what comes up from the ground.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank you. Talk of Shit Storm Tour, Day 5. The Gray Swarm's open for Turtle Smash the night I OD'd here. Or so the police report said, anyway. I was 15 years old. When I woke in the hospital, 2 days later, your face was the first thing I saw.
This is useful.
Hunt is over.
these will keep. Saving these for the trail. Hunting me. Exactly. Lion's thirsty for rain. Me, not so much. All right. Bad feeling. Show your face so I can slice it off. Healing supplies. Lucky. Thank you. There's the alarm. Better keep an eye on it.
Blast it. Man down. Hey! Someone killed one of us!
There's the prisoners.
His fault. It made him sick, too.
Spotted something! You hear that? Hearing things?
Thank you. That one's up.
I need to keep my kit dry. I'm gonna get you out. I'm not leaving you in here. That's right. No one here.
You a coward? Face me! Are you even looking over there?
Calm. Looks like I'm clear.
I'm gonna check that out. Something over here. Huh? Heard something.
If we don't rally, we're... Whoa!
Still got it.
You can see them. I can't see you. Can breathe again.
Couldn't find him. Spit on it.
I'll tuck that away.
full already. Stocking up. Tasty. Thank you. This'll last. Good meat. Snowfall. Getting colder.
Thank you. Keep that for later. This has to be the Banuk camp that Vilgan told me about. So what happened to the other mercenaries he sent?
Honor to your work.
This is how the Banuk must have gotten up and down the mountain.
The last hunt was a good one. Struck swift as snow, and none will be going hungry.
But it will require cunning.
must be tough to have ventured out of their territory.
Shaman, you're trying to understand the machines here too?
Yes, Nora. And taking my time with my studies. Between you, me, and the spirits, I appreciate the peace. Not just from the machines. There are many changes in Ban-Ur. The hunters and shamans bicker without end.
What about?
How best to deal with a harsher world? The hunters, they don't want it back the way it used to be. And we shamans find ourselves able to explain less and less. So many are exiles now, sent to wander. Here, no one argues. So, I welcome mystery. Perhaps the machines are glad to be separated from their herds, too.
I might need that.
Greetings, Nora. I am Tikuk.
Shaman, I've never seen anything like this.
The blue light is strong here. My people traveled far from the heights of Ban-Ur to experience it for themselves.
The blue light?
The light of the machine spirits. It is all around us. It settles upon us. This is how it used to be, before they grew angry.
I know about the derangement, but I didn't think the machines were ever this calm. What is it about this place?
We don't really know. We sing, and we listen to the machine songs.
Tikuk, have any other Outlanders come through here recently?
Some Asaram, yes. They were convinced the machines were malfunctioning. As if machines were mere devices in need of repair. Well, that is how the Asaram see the world, is it not? They ate with us. Then, when they were satisfied there was nothing they could explain, they left with the Northern Light.
The machines sing to you?
To each other. You are a hunter. You must have heard their communions and hymns, their calls and cries. We're not meant to understand, but we shamans try to interpret. What is the song that angered them so, that turned them upon us? What song soothes them? Does it thrum in the air here, just outside of hearing? How can we heal the machine world?
What's with the big guy?
I was drawn to this place in a storm. At first, I thought the keening was the wind, snapping off the mountain's frozen face. But no, it was the Thunderjaw's song. I found it crouched on its haunches, its metal unmoving, and I took shelter beneath it. When the storm cleared, its singing done, perhaps the spirit left its great shell. Or perhaps it slumbers and remains. So we have not stripped and gleaned this one. We treat it with the care it is owed.
Do you mind if I look around more, Tikuk?
Speak, trade, listen. You are welcome. No harm will come to you here.
So it's not the Banuk that are doing this. There's something about this place. They can't see it, but maybe my focus can.
It's in the spirit's favor.
these machines. Up close like this, it's...
Grazer dung.
I'm sorry?
Frozen grazer dung. This Ravager led me here. I chased it down from the rivals, where it killed a great ice hunter. Tore him in two. A challenge I accepted. But when it reached this camp, the Fury left it.
Isn't that a good thing?
Tekuk says it's a gift. What is a gift but a reward that you didn't earn? The machines are meant to challenge us. Now I'm stuck here guarding the shamans. I can feel myself growing cold.
I've looked into the blue light, and only found more questions.
But his lands are hard to live. Hunting here is relaxing.
This is how the Banuk must have gotten up and down the mountain. Fine, I guess.
Quite beyond your jumping shard purses! You can't just leave us here!
Did Vilgun send you? I guess shards can buy a conscience.
Never mind that. Nora girl, you have to stop the others. Up ahead, we snuck up, uncovered some kind of ancient device, plain as an anvil. That's what affects the machines.
The other bungheads voted to take it to Pitchcliff for auction. But it's taken a beating already. Like it dropped from the sky.
But we tried to stop them digging it out. Without that thing up here, those Banuk will be massacred.
I'll stop them. You two get out of here. It sounds like you've already done enough damage.
Well, that's a fair appraisal.
Thank you.
clothes.
You bunch of chuff skulls.
White as bone. What have you done?
Who are you? You're not one of those Banuk.
Too late. Let me look at it.
Hold on. This was our delve. We did the work. You want to put your axe in? What's this thing worth to you?
I don't know about this. This was your idea. You started it, you can finish.
All right. Could be this thing's just scrap, but even scrap has a price. So I'll ask again, what's it worth to you?
It's worth more to me than you are. You still want to negotiate?
Forget it. All ye's ever given me is black toes.
They've made a mess of this. Catastrophic malfunction. This is from long ago. And it's been sending a signal all this time. Fading out. I have to get back to the camp before the machines tear it apart. No, they've already started attacking.
The hunt is back.
The machines are angered. Keep your distance. Hunters, defend the camp. Do what you must.
Yes. Roar and rend at me. I don't fear. Hear my song, machine. A sharp song.
Nora, did you know this change would come upon us?
Not exactly. Although I know there is a lot changing in our world. This time it was outsiders. Those Oseram thought.
The Oseram do not think. They will never understand the balance between us. Between man and machine. Now the blue light has gone. And we are left with many songs. But more for mourning than gratitude.
So what now? Will you go back to your homeland?
When we teach the young to walk on shifting ice, we say, the secret is taking one step, then the next. Perhaps one day, we will understand the machine's mysteries.
I hope so. Good luck, Tikuk.
Save these for the trail.
Might as well try to catch the light in your hand.
A fine day ahead.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family.
Outlander, are you looking for...
Wait. I know your face.
You came back! How did we fare?
Expensively.
That's what I was afraid of.
The tame machines... It's hard to explain, but there was a kind of signal that calmed them. Your men got greedy, so it's gone now.
Gambling's a shoddy job, girl. I should have been a weapons dealer. That's steady work. Here, take it. The half I'd owed those hammer-handed chunks.
Half? I finished the job. And what was it you said? Enough to buy a more becoming garb?
What do you want? Carja silks? Ah, hoisted on my own purse strings. You again. I never forget a face I've lost shards to.
I think I'm about to have some fun.
Better come out.
Hardy little plant. You'll help. Need them soon enough. That'll help. Tough, but I'm used to it.
They say the Nora women ask men to come back. However,
this must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
That plane owed Ursa.
No sign of Murad's guy. He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Kept the wheel turning all day. By the forge, I believe I've earned a drink or two. Here's the spot, eh? I made you.
Well, someone left here recently, and they were in a hurry.
Has to be Murad's guy. Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps, you know you better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
And my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
I think I'm in the clear.
Looks like they've been chained up.
Durval's a tinker. He probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
Thank you. Get off your bums and search.
Killing us! Look!
Is that... Yeah, trouble! Sneak off! I'm coming for you, girl!
Val says you gotta eat dirt.
Thank you. We have to get through.
They must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound.
Durval tried to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Durval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. Now listen, Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little brother.
Ursa. No, no. Please. I won't let you down. I promise.
Erend, I'm so sorry.
You've got to find Durval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down.
I'll head back to Meridian. I'll just need a little time.
What's Durval learned from all his tinkering? Do I even want to know? This machine's been picked apart with precision. Durval's records, maybe. Such a strange device. It's beautifully crafted. Just notes about crafting. Oh, and a letter tucked between the pages. Lots of blaze. Headed to Meridian. If we find it, I'll bet we find Durval too. What happens when I turn it on?
I think I've got it working. There. Now, say something. Both of you, Doves.
I don't know. What do you want me to say?
Whatever you want. I just want to hear your voice and keep it for later.
I'll sing, Papa. La 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 la.
There. A song and a laugh. Even better than words. And now I can hear them whenever I want.
We're done, then? Off to bed with you.
Good night, Mama. Good night, Papa.
Is she gone? What are we going to do? The raids are getting closer and closer to Main Spring. How much longer can we hide like this?
A keepsake from his family. Derval's got nothing left to lose. I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.
Heavy. It's hard, too.
Seems full of smiles.
Crier. We all have our place in the order of things.
Move along. You have no need to loiter around here.
I've sent a messenger to the claim to let everyone know.
If there's anything you or your clan need for her arrangements, you need but ask.
There'll be time for all of that later.
Aloy. I'm glad you're back. I'm at a loss about Ursa. To learn she lives, then lose that hope seems cruel.
She wouldn't want us to waste time talking. She'd want us to find Dervahl. She said he raved about smoke darkening the sun. Tell him what you found in his papers.
A letter. It mentioned a shipment of Blaze being sent to a warehouse here. Only, it wasn't addressed to Dervahl. The name was Aeland Forgeman. Does that mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar. Yes, a landlord. The Oseram have been buying up buildings across the city, including one under that name. Let me think. It's by the edge of the mesa, near the temple. Used to be a shop, but it could serve as a warehouse. If Dervahl used the name as an alias to buy it, he might even be there now.
I'll round up my men.
I'll meet you there.
Erend, wait. Remember that no one hates Dervahl more than your own tribe. The clans would give up much to obtain him.
Take him alive? So you can haggle over him? You can't be serious!
Our security depends on keeping the peace. If the opportunity presents itself, take him alive. Consider that a command. Aloy, a moment, please. When we spoke, Aaron didn't wish to dwell on the details of Ursa's death. Understandable, of course. But now that they've been left to my imagination, those details are all I can think about. You were there. Did she suffer?
She wasn't worried about her pain. She was worried about her brother. And she was worried about you.
Thank you, Aloy. I suppose I needed to know I was as much on her mind as she is on mine. Find Dervahl and bring him before me. He will answer for his crimes. Don't let me delay you any longer. Meet Erend at the warehouse.
Everyone needs a splash of color in their lives. Come, let's talk it over.
What did you want to talk about?
You were an outlander, no? An adventurer. I used to be one myself. I admit, I miss the beguiling colors of the wilds. Speaking of which, I wonder if you've come across a very special kind of flower. It's made of metal, like a machine. Other blossoms grow around them in amazing patterns. These gleaming beauties are very much in demand among my clients. If you bring me some, I have valuables to trade for them.
You said you were an adventurer.
Just so. The nobles of Meridian crave flowers for their balconies and gardens. So out I went, with bow and spear. I made my name by searching the wilds for the wildest blossoms. No bandit nor machine could keep me from those precious petals.
So what happened?
Love happened, my sweet. My paramour frets too much when I venture out. So now I collect flowers for those without such bonds.
Is it worth it? Being restrained like that?
Of course. Freedom is sweet, but the embrace of my beautiful Theridine is sweeter still.
These metal flowers, what are they exactly?
No one knows, but some say they began sprouting 20 years ago when the machine started to go mad. Perhaps they grow from the tears of the sun, for he has many faces, does he not? Wrathful one day, cool and patient the next? Perhaps he weeps for our suffering when his anger breaks. Ah, let us haggle over this beautiful bounty. Till we meet again, my noble Nora. I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy.
This is the place! You home, Derval? I got a surprise for you!
Or he has a surprise for us.
Is it a bomb? Doesn't look too big.
It's a bomb, all right. Big enough to kill us.
All right. I'll shut up.
Blaze. It must be leaking from something upstairs. If I try to take it apart, a booby trap will set it off.
That's a lot of blaze.
If that bomb downstairs goes off, it'll be just what Derval promised. Smoke will darken the sun. As the city goes up in flames, there's gotta be a way to stop it. If we can get rid of it somehow, the blast will be much smaller. If we can get rid of it somehow, the blast will be much smaller. Maybe there's some way I can open this window to get rid of the fuel. If that bomb goes off, the blaze will ignite in a firestorm. It looks like a wooden bracket. Not very strong. Help me push this out.
Okay. Brute force. I'm good at that. What'll it do?
Save the city, I hope. But when the blaze falls, run for it. Because the booby trap on the bomb downstairs is gonna get set off.
Will we survive?
Probably not. Now push.
Ugh.
We did it!
Durval's best shot, and Meridian's still standing.
This isn't over. Durval said he'd make a VOD watch.
No way. To do that, he'd have to get into the palace. Now that's too heavily guarded.
Get back there, just to be sure. I'm gonna look around. Maybe Durval's men left something behind when they planted that bomb.
I got it. Don't worry. If he tries for the palace, he's finished.
Boot tracks. With just a bit of blaze in them.
Can I interest you in a reasonable share of a lucrative opportunity?
Get to the fire and shut up a bucket line!
What happened?
I haven't heard a blast like that since the liberation.
Let's have a chat. No, a colorful discussion.
There's smoke rising from the edge of the mesa.
Are we under attack? The tracks lead inside. Another one of Durval's hideouts. Must be where Durval assembled the detonator. He tunneled through the wall. Durval did find a way into the palace.
Wish I could be there to see the sun god on his knees.
Quit carping, you chuff. Someone's gotta guard the rear.
Someone's gotta guard the rear.
Look at you, Avad. The wriggling runt of a maniac king. You robbed me of my right to kill your father, so I'll have to settle for you. I'm going to enjoy watching the Karja burn, even more because you'll be watching with me. Say goodbye to Meridian, Avad. Breathe in the sky. stench and choke on the ashes. Something's wrong. I didn't hear anything.
There's a bit of smoke rising from the mesa's edge.
No! It should be a firestorm, not some belch from a charcoal burner!
This'll help.
What's this? Oh. You must be the Nora who bushwhacked my camp.
And disabled your bomb.
Did you now? Well, bomb or no bomb, I'm gonna splatter that throne with blood. First yours, then Avad's.
Something there!
Why does Avad have his ladies do the fighting?
Your end has...
I've led an army, killed kestrels and ravagers, a savage for nothing. Can we finish this? I've got a sun god to kill.
You...
Why does Avad always have his ladies fighting?
Haven't you got anything better to do?
You cannot come.
I've led an army. Killed kestrels and ravagers. A savage is nothing. Can we finish this? I've got a sun god. Why does Avad always have his late in the fight? I've led an army. Killed kestrels and ravagers. A savage is nothing.
Save this for later.
We've got company!
It's not over yet, Nora. Any good Oseram Tinker will tell you. Always have a third plan. Because there's more on the way!
Got you!
As much as I wish Ursa was here to kill you, I don't mind doing it for her.
Go ahead. I'm not afraid. Except that knowing you, Aaron, you'll screw it up!
I know what you are afraid of. Going back to Mainspring in chains. Every clan in the claim wants you dead. And they know how to make it hurt. They'll even bid for the privilege.
It's just like you to get someone else to do your killing.
Shut up. You're at the Sun King's mercy now.
I always knew that Nora would come to a bad.
Let's have a chat. No, a colorful discussion.
Come to gloat, Nora. Well, as you can see, I'm busy. I get it. You want to rub it in? Well, it's not working. Ha ha! It's funny to pester the Tinker in the cage. What a laugh. You think that bit of scrap on your brow makes you smart? I'll bet you couldn't have taken apart my bomb without it. Think I'm done? Think again. I've gotten out of worse scrapes. While the lunkheads in Mainspring dither over how to kill me, I'll dig myself out. Just you wait. When I get out of here, I'm gonna fight.
Here, see for yourself.
Could you spare a moment to speak of the fire things?
Aloy, to say you have my gratitude feels woefully insufficient. You saved my life. You saved Meridian. And because of you, there will be justice for Ursa's murder. We can mourn her knowing the truth without painful uncertainty. It's hard to imagine where we'd be without you. And I don't want to try. I hope you will consider staying in Meridian.
Were you and Ursa, you know?
I suppose it's obvious how I feel. How I felt about her. She didn't just give me advice. She gave me strength.
but we couldn't be together. Relations between the Karja and Oseram and Meridian were unsteady as it was. The union of the Sun King and an Oseram warrior would have led to open revolt in the city. And probably war with the clans.
Did anyone know?
Only one. Derval. He wanted Ursa, but she rejected him. And so jealousy became yet another of his hateful motivations.
What exactly will happen to Derval?
For now, he'll languish in one of the old cells under the Sunring here in Meridian. As for what happens after we negotiate his extradition to Mainspring, I don't want to think about it. My father was very creative when it came to inflicting suffering. But some Oseram devices surpass even his imaginings. What a waste. Derval is a brilliant man. I wonder what he would have accomplished if it weren't for my father's cruelty.
Why do you want me to stay in Meridian?
Well, I would think that would be obvious.
Not to me.
Well, to start with, you kept the city from going up in flames. You're strong, shrewd, and capable. I could use someone like you at my side.
Thank you for the offer, but I don't think either you or I are ready for that. At least, not yet. I've got a long way to go before I find what I'm looking for, and it's gonna take me far from Meridian.
Of course. I didn't mean to presume. You are your own woman, just as Ursa was. But please, remember that you're always welcome here. I hope that today is just a sunrise for us, not a goodbye.
It's time for me to go.
Of course. I hope you find what you're after, Aloy. And if need be, I will come to your aid. As sure as the sun's rising.
Aloy. I was just thinking about Ursa. She would have killed Derval on the spot. I know it. That's why she went out to meet him in the first place, to put him down. But she also told me to grow up. I gotta admit, it burned a little when she said that, but I'm trying to take it to heart. And I guess growing up means putting what you should do in front of what you want to do. Right?
You're asking me? I'm pretty sure you're older.
Yeah, but I don't act like it, do I?
You did with Derval.
Now, don't give me too much credit. Part of me still wants to wait for a quiet moment and wring his neck.
Yeah, but you won't. Because you're a good captain.
Come on, stop. You're gonna make me tear up.
So, after all this, what's next for Errand Vanguardsman?
Heading back to the claim for a while. I'll get in touch with my clan and we'll lay Ursa to rest properly. Like how she would have wanted. And by that I mean, less chit-chat, more drinking.
What do you think the Oseram will do to Derval?
First off, they'll argue about it for a long time. But whatever they come up with, it won't be quick. I can live with that. In fact, I might just drop by his cell under the Sun Ring to remind him what's coming.
Well,
I know. You gotta go. Killers to track, machines to master. All before breakfast. You know what? When we met, I thought I was a big shot talking to a pretty girl hidden away in the middle of nowhere. And now I see that I was just lucky to get a minute of your time. Try not to forget about me while you're out there changing the world.
I'll always have a minute for you. Maybe even two.
Two? Huh. She likes me.
Your errand is behind the vault. If you're lost.
I've seen this before. I've seen better. Oh, wonderful.